morning, everybody. Let's see. I'm going to do another little gouache sketch, a little painting of the cow. And I'm using a reference on Instagram from my friend Harry Dingman's Instagram account in Cochise County. So that's the picture I'm going to reference. For those of you that are curious, you could follow him or whatever. He's got a lot of cool pictures on there. And now I'm going to draw that cow. Let's see. Big shapes first. Kind of stylize it a little bit. And an ear. Head. Well, I hope the internet is good. I know yesterday there were some problems because of the weather. We had some bad weather, and it was interrupting or messing up my internet connection, but hopefully now it's better. Hello, thanks for joining. I am drawing a cow right now that I will be painting using Instagram as reference. One of my friend's Instagram accounts. He's a cattle rancher in southeastern Arizona, so why not draw a cow? Let's see. As always, let me know if you guys have any questions. Just trying to figure out the different planes of the face here. And then right under the jaw comes out. Hey, McDon91. Thanks for joining. In the morning, I'll do some sketches. And usually I sketch in my sketchbook to warm up. But I've been picking a few days where I actually sketch on postcards. And so that's what this is. This is all be a postcard, and I will send it with some artwork to a friend, family member. Let's see. Cow's nose, kind of like that, a little bit flatter on the top, a little more of a scoop in the jaw, and then the neck kind of comes out, shoulder, and behind the ear, right there. The hips, kind of boxy. Let's see. And this will probably, I'm going to use a very limited palette when I paint this, and I'm really enjoying that. And I'll show you guys what I mean. I know some of you guys are artists, and maybe you can commiserate with me, but I love listening to music and audiobooks and or a podcast when I'm drawing or painting in the studio. And when I'm doing these live videos, I can't listen to music because, you know, I don't have the rights to it or whatever. So instead, it's just silence. Unless I want to put my headphones on. But then, let's see, I'm going to lower the horizon line to about right there. Yeah. And the picture that I'm using to reference, guys, it's, you know, during the day, I'll show you. So it's that picture on Instagram right there. And it's a friend of mine. He gave me permission to draw and paint just for practice, you know. So anyway, even though that it's a daytime image, kind of, I'm going to make it a little darker, a little bit more nocturne. So this is my palette. It'll be ivory white, cobalt blue, alizarin crimson, yellow ochre, and white. So ivory black, white, and just three colors, and black and white. And it'll be a very limited palette, but I think I'll get good results. I might add in some highlights later. Hey, Lily. Thanks for joining. All right. Maybe I'll do this more often, a little bit more regularly, where I'll share my morning sketches. Because usually I have my cup of coffee, and I'm really careful not to dip my brush into it. All right. And this is my basic setup. I mean, it's really simple. I got my image I'm referencing, my paint, my brushes, and my coffee. So that's my basic setup right there. Anyway, all right, let's... Okay, and if you guys have any questions at all, just... How you doing? If you guys want to comment stuff too, you can. You don't have to have a question. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is try and get the background really, really dark. And I'm mixing alizarin crimson, cobalt blue to get some of that dark. And I'm using opaque gouache. Using it very thick. Not really pulling it along too much, just laying it down. I enjoy sending artwork in the mail. Well, little postcards with sketches or letters that have a little painting. And so the reason why I chose this cow to paint is because I really liked the angle of the horns, how they looked. Well, I think you guys hear my heater turning on in the background. I hope it's not too noisy. Yeah, I'm having fun with the blockiness of the sky using a square brush. Very basic palette here. I'm gonna have to turn this just a little bit. Usually when I paint these small things, I am turning them all the time, trying to get the best angle. But I'm a little hesitant to do that in the video, just because I'll get carried away and I don't know, I might make it too dizzy. All right, so now I'm mixing a little bit of yellow ochre and white just for the bottom part here where I want to just lighten up the horizon line a little bit. I want to make it more yellow too. Yellow orange, I should say. It's not all the time where I get to use the color right out of the tube. Usually I'm mixing quite a lot . I've learned to enjoy color mixing. I'm just softening the edge of that yellow ochre line with the blue. Okay, I kind of like that. Nice. And then like a blue mountain range in the back. And for that, I'm using blue with a little bit of black and a little bit of red. I recently did my first couple of paintings after being inspired by your work. What? That's awesome. Thanks for sharing that, Billy. Would you always start from the background and work into the foreground? That's a good question. Not always. Let's see. I'm trying to think of instances where I don't. I did a painting of my wife brushing a horse, and I just kind of jumped into it. It was an oil painting, and there's a video of it on my YouTube channel. It's Jackie and Dancer. In that video, I paint Jackie and the horse first, and then later I go in and paint the background. I did that just because I didn't really know what I wanted to do with the background. I was referencing a photo and I didn't really like the background of the photo. That's a good question. Thanks for asking. All right, and the foreground, I'm thinking I'm gonna make it like a bleached green. So I'm gonna use white with yellow ochre and blue. Well, you guys can't even see me mixing colors. Here, that way you can see me mix it a little bit. So I'll pick up blue with my brush, put it down. That gives me kind of a green color. I need a little bit more white in there. A little bit more blue. And it doesn't look like a green wood, like a grass. But it's a limited palette, and so it's just enough of a green that when I put it down here on the paper, it looks green enough. Let's see, pick up a bunch of paint. And then I'm gonna make it real dark. Kind of make this cow stand out just a little bit. So black and red. A lot more red. Maybe a little bit of white. And I'm still using the same brush. Just a big, well, big for this canvas, a half inch brush. I'm trying to cover as much of the surface area as I can in the beginning. Using some of this dry brush technique. There we go. That looks good. I'm liking it so far. Now, with the other ones that I've done, I've sprinkled some stars and splatters. I love doing that. I like letting paint be paint and having some fun with it. So I usually use my fan brush like this. Can you see this? Yeah. So I'm mixing up a little puddle. You have to practice it so you get the viscosity right, because you don't want to be splattering. Well, at least I don't want to splatter and get stripes. I don't want it to be too soupy. If it's soupy and viscous, it'll give you stripes like that. So what I want is a viscosity so that it's not too wet and not too syrupy. If it's too wet, it splatters, and that's not fun. So pink is a nice bright color that I think will look good here and there. So I'll just add some subtle texture to my landscape. You can barely see that, right? And then orange. I think I can mix some orange with the yellow ochre and red. I'll just use some of this pink. Well, it looks kind of pink still. There we go, starting to look more orange. All right. I think I'm going to wet it a little bit more. And I really try and keep a time limit. I don't want to do, go over an hour making these. I feel like an hour is a good amount of time. And I think Instagram cuts me off at like an hour anyway. All right, so got to get moving then. Time to paint this cow. And you can see in the reference the larger shapes of the cow. It's like this black shape there, brown shape, and kind of the speckled shape. Those are the color shapes that I'm going to be copying. So I squint my eyes to simplify them. When I'm looking at the cow, I squint my eyes just a little bit. And that helps me simplify the form. So, mixing up some brown with red, yellow, and blue. Some nice dark brown that's kind of on the red side. The ear. The cheek. The neck area. Let's see. And got the heater starting up again, thank goodness. I know it's really chilly in other parts of the U.S. right now. And I'm in Long Beach going, oh, it's so cold. It's 60 degrees. Yeah. California. I wonder how cold it is wherever you guys are. Where my dad is, in southeastern Arizona, he sent me a picture this morning of snow on the ground, which is a rare sight in southeastern Arizona. Let's see, bottom of the horns. I use a big brush for most of the painting. I feel like you can turn it on its edge and use the angles quite a bit. Even for like this little detail, the eye, which I don't really need to be painting right now. Let's see, the nostril. The other legs. And then the divot right here on the shoulder. The belly. Cool. So I have my dark areas blocked in. Time for a sip of coffee. It's been a moment. Ah, that's nice. All right. And then I have a very battered brush like this. And I like it. I like my roughed up brushes. They have nice paint application. So with a little bit lighter color, I'm going back in and I don't want it to be so transparent. I want it to be opaque, just lighter. Maybe I'm pulling this brush into the mix too soon. Gotta be bold with this paint. Use a lot of it. All right. Let's see. I like that. I'm gonna splatter some spots on this hide, on the cowhide. But instead of white, look, see the little white spots on the cowhide. Instead of white, I think I might do blue, like a baby blue. Because it's night, you know? There. That works a little bit better. Too small. Dang, it's really viscous. Okay. Water it down just a hair. I think I might just have to apply it, which is fine. Interesting choice of brush, Daniel. What am I doing? I guess I'm just having fun still. Yeah, and that's about the texture right there. I've said it before and I'll say it in probably every video I paint. I like painting the nose with a little bit more pink than there actually is. Same thing with the ears. got a smaller brush now. Let's see, trying to get a little closer to a finished painting. I don't want to be too sloppy with my paint application. In fact, I gotta tighten it up here. An interesting portrait of a cow so far. Maybe a little darker right in the middle of the ear, under the jaw. This is looking good. Of this shoulder. All right. The horns. Now I can add a little bit of highlight to those horns and make it kind of a yellow white, as yellow white as I can get. Let's see. There, I think that looks good. Kind of outline the ear a little bit. The same way. Cool. Not bad. I like my little bovine. Maybe I'll do a buffalo next or something. Well, before I call this one finished, I'm gonna play around and do some accents. And for that, I'm gonna use this little tube of color. Not too brilliant, not straight from the tube. Gonna bleach it down a little bit. Mixing it with white and a little bit of blue. Just a little bit. So this color I'm going to put into the background a little bit. Maybe I made a mistake there. Maybe I didn't. Maybe that was unnecessary. I don't think that highlight even, I don't think you can even tell it's there. Just defining the lips a little bit better. And then there's like these little spots of color or that are the paper and that's just poking through the paint. They're a little distracting, so I'm gonna try and cover those up. Hey guys, thanks for joining again. El Charro and Just Hershey. Antonio, thank you for joining. If you guys have any questions, feel free to ask or comments or whatever. All right. So this was fun, just a little morning sketch with my coffee. This will be a little postcard for a friend of mine. Using a limited palette, basically three colors, yellow ochre, alizarin crimson, cobalt blue, black, white, and I used this brighter orange right here, but I don't think it was necessary. I used it as an accent, and that's the reference I used. I played around with the color a little bit more, making a little bit more dramatic. So, hope you guys enjoyed that. Sorry about the poor connection. In my garage, maybe I'll move my little setup to inside the next time I do this. So, anyway, I might clean up this a little bit more, but it's basically done. I think it's basically done. Little highlight on the nose, maybe. And the lip. A little dot in the eye. Cool. So, hope you guys enjoyed. Later.